pause is right. Here is stucco, decorative stucco. I call it stone stretcher because it's just cinder block with stucco on top. Of course, we got our stains in it. Look, we're going for over here. A lot of two-tone buffs and charcoals. And this is going to be tough pointed and then rebeaded. Just did these last night, so just about done here. So it turned out really good. We got this about 60-foot wall here that we did around it. A little bit more to do right here. This area right here is coming close. We're going to push pause and then hopefully kind of school on how we do this. It's my lovely wife. She's helping me with this wonderful job here. So bear with us.
Freeze powder
right in the water.
I remember freeze beat, but never freeze powder.
Yeah, it's gonna last longer. Put about 2 cups in a 5 gallon bucket. Give or take a few. Melts right away that way. The beads take about 5-10 minutes.
Beads go right away.
Yeah, go ahead.
And this is going on the wall that...
on the front there, yeah, but we gotta get the flamethrower on there.
Okay.
I'm sure it's defrosted. I already had it on there for a little bit, but we've been over here, so...
All right.
Go ahead and push pause and we'll move it.
Go up here for a better angle. Extremely low.
but a little bit bigger. Already done down here prior to this, but we're gonna go ahead and put slurry over it so we get a nice stick and texture combination going with the color. We want this ledge to show porch, so we want to look a little bit more set back, corbelled in. We don't want to take that miter off there because we're gonna be putting this look like a cap, but this is block two, you can see. We're gonna make it look like one big cap. So what we got going on is it got hot, so I turned off the heater. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna just draw some of this moisture out, kind of like a syringe. You just kind of hold it, squeeze it in, and you should let loose a little bit. And you can see how the aggregate starts to show up, that your moisture is getting out of it. You want to make sure that this doesn't move before you move on to the next step. So you might be here for about, you know, 2 or 3 minutes, and just making sure you squeeze it all out. Otherwise you'll have what you call air pockets and parts that didn't bond. And then you'll have to, you'll see areas where they fell off next year or whatever. You don't want to do that. You really want to kind of think of it as a brick being set. If you hit it too many times when you're setting it, one too many times, then you're going to break the bond. So what you want to make sure is you kind of look at that math for sense, because this is a lot smaller, these little aggregates, you know, so you got to kind of use a soft brush or a soft sponge and just kind of tap it until it won't move anymore. And then you just got to kind of use your judgment on that. Don't cheat yourself, because it's not worth it in the end. And I like to get these corners kind of straight, so it gives a definition like it was chipped, or pitched rather, with a chisel. And it just gives it a really nice clean edge there. You can just feather that back. We're gonna stain this next. Okay, so same thing, you proceed with the stuff that's bigger. And so you might be here for another few minutes, so you can go ahead and pitch the spade for the drier stuff on the bottom. We're gonna apply some color. Since we're working with a block and a charcoal, I just went ahead and made some two colors. I got more colors than that, but I've been finding that these two colors work pretty good together. You still got the gray. I don't like to have it necessarily wet like this when I do it on top, but because of the sake of the video, we've got a little section down here. You can imagine when this gets a little drier, like say tonight, like maybe about 4 or 5 hours, then you would want to go ahead and do this next process that I'm showing you down on the bottom. So I just kind of get a base coat. I guess you can call it like a primer. And just dry up here, so I'm going to go ahead and get this. This is where I got it dirty. Instead of acid washing, we'll just restain it. We got the formula. Be careful the splatters don't get all over the place. New patio. You could use a brush. Pour it, use sponges, really up to you, and how thick you want it, how transparent you want it, pretty much up to you. And then my secret, I'm not getting any younger. I would have hoped by now, my kids would have mastered this, but they think that rough to work with, I guess. So they all work. They're doing successfully their own thing. One of them is doing fencing. Well, they're both doing fencing. One of them owns his own business. They're both working for somebody right now because they weren't able to sleep here in the winter. So that seems like a tough business. Wide open room down there for 20 more companies. I'm not really too worried if anybody figures this out and does a good job. We're saving the north end is the way I look at it. I mean, you can't find this kind of stone anywhere that's already been aged this antique color. And so my wife and I were just online last night looking up words to figure out what to call this. And you know, the word antique stone came out, you know, didn't know what to do. Historical stone, you know, it's 100 years old, so it's got this black all over it. And I think it looks really cool. But you can't find it anywhere unless you tear something down. And most people that tear it down want to use it for what else they do. Here we can just go ahead and do an add-on to a house that's got some older stuff. Example, let's say you stand over here and kind of look at the porch from here with this wall. This is still a little wet over here, but when this dries, the colors are like this end here. And if you look at both of them together, you can't tell there's a difference. So when we come in with our colors onto the house, you're not going to be able to tell at all, because we can tint it either direction. These, we're going to go ahead and put charcoal on those, because the original has a little bit of the charcoal on it right here. So we're going to try to match this two-tone look over here. I think this whole wall needs to get done and be more like these beads here. It looks like this got all washed out over here on this over here. I don't know what happened over here, but I would recommend that this get ripped out and redone over here. So this is where we tied in right here. Of course, it's still wet. But here's some of the drier stuff on the end here. Church that somebody's converted into his own house, and so that's why some of the windows are shaped the way they are. And I'm really cool inside, man. I've heard of doing a school like that in Cuna, but this is the north end, the high end area, and this historical church now has become a residence. So, cool stuff. Cool part of history here. Have to be a part of something. Okay, so. Now that we've got most of the black on that, this stuff, well, let me get some on this top part. Don't worry about if you get too messy. Just remember there's a lot of parts where we can stop and go over it really fast and really easy, especially if it's dry. So it's really fast. So I'm just going to put like a, just to tap it back, make sure it's still set. See how set up it is now? Already, it's not moving. That's what you want. You want it to quit moving on you. I'm just tapping it. Love taps right now. And I'm just might as well use a little bit of stain since we got to set it some more. We already sucked the moisture out of it. There we go. Now we're getting a nice thing. See, now the sand is starting to get polished. And that's what I like. I think that's what makes it sparkle in the sunlight. Gives it that realism look. Like the pastel chalk stuff that they covered all the sand and everything all together. That doesn't fly with me. Couldn't put that up next to this house and say that it's the same, man. Never do that. I want a sponge here. My board does her board, does two of her own boards, and does mine. And those big daubers things that you go marking all the numbers. That's kind of what she does. Smack. Well, let's try not to get ideas of this. Anyway, wet. Because I'm so impatient. I mean, it looks so real, you can't tell sometimes. Sometimes you can't tell. So, a little bit too much, I think, so I'm going to put a little bit more here. We'll probably wait till this dries so you won't get to see it. But you've seen what it looks like on the other part of the video. Areas. Plus, we're going to go ahead and end this by scanning the wall, and then you'll see the credits going up. Thank you. That's my wife, Yolanda, that's videoing. And just kind of do a nice little perimeter walk, just like that, and then stop it where you feel like it should end.
Awesome church. Now it's a home. Thank you for viewing, and don't forget to subscribe.